YouTube is screwing up again. I know. They have such an amazing track record of being pro creator.
YouTube has still done nothing.
They have an amazing copyright content ID system, and as the paragons they are, they would never show favoritism to a certain pair of brothers who showed a dead body that committed suicide, threw parties during the height of the pandemic, and actively looted during the Black Lives Matter protest. What has YouTube in hot water now is that a popular creator known as Moist Critical, or Charlie, received a strike on his channel for reacting and commenting on a fake road rage incident involving people in cartoon mascot costumes. Yes, I said that sentence, it's 2020. Anyways, he receives a strike and the video is removed. Markiplier and Charlie both point out that Markiplier didn't receive a strike for reacting to the same video. Now, let's play a game. It's time for, what did YouTube do this time? Did YouTube A, realize their overreaching action and remove the strike from Charlie and apologize? B, communicate out what saved Markiplier from a community strike and clarify a vague and problematic rule, thus allowing the community to better understand the guidelines? Or C, strike Markiplier 2 with no reason given to just at least appear consistent and piss off the creator base? The answer was C as I was writing this script. However, when hashtag AnswerUsYouTube started trending, the answer became A. YouTube admitted it was an overreaction and rescinded the strike. By the way, did you know there are still animal abusers on YouTube? They seem to be fine. Animal abuse. YouTube is A-OK with that. Fake roadside furry violence. Too far unless you can get a hashtag trending. Look up a Man of the Jedi's video on it. It's spicy. YouTube has always had its issues, from content ID to DMCA being used as a censorship tool. Then there was COPPA, and even the adjustments YouTube makes to its recommendation algorithm has killed entire genres before. Rest in peace to actual animation channels. YouTube making a mistake is not the egregious part of this. We all make mistakes. It's to be expected. The core comes down to two issues. One, YouTube's nasty habit of playing favorites when they say they don't. And two, their near incompetent lack of communication. I touched on YouTube playing favorites back in the Dear YouTube Let's Rant. You can watch it for added context. That being said, favoritism hasn't been a new thing. There are top tier creators on this platform that have scammed their fan base, such as the previously mentioned Paul brothers, Tana Mongoose Mongo, hey Virgil, can you flash her name? Bryce Gum, and a whole host of others. Heck, even one of the Paul brothers has now been raided by the FBI due to his involvement in looting in Arizona and has been charged. He and the one that filmed the dead body are still on this platform while Lofi got the boot with no warning. Sure, it can easily be argued that Lofi was a massive bully and a cause of harassment on this platform, but he never ran any dropshipping scams, Tana. He never tried to convince his young audience to illegally participate in real-life loot boxes, Rice Gum. He's also, to my knowledge, never been charged in Arizona for participating in looting and then trying to hide behind BLM protests to gain sympathy points. While YouTube has problematic top-tier creators, they decide to go at Charlie and Markiplier for laughing at dudes beating people up in fursuits. When this platform has active animal abusers and people that have questionable actions with minors, YouTube decides in their infinite big-brained wisdom to go after Markiplier because he had a few giggles at a road rage mascot beatdown? This reeks of favoritism. Did you know Shane Dawson still has a channel despite sexualizing Willow Smith and a ton of other questionable statements and actions? Did you know Nisian still has a channel despite the laundry list of people he has harassed and minors he's had questionable interactions with? You see my point. YouTube is either playing favorites or has Twitch-level inconsistent moderators, and they are too far up their own poop chutes to admit it. Let's move on to the other part that has made YouTube an absolute nightmare to work with when something goes wrong. Fun fact, we at one point received a community guideline strike during a live stream. We figured maybe we'd said something a tad bit too spicy and changed what we talked about, only for our stream to be taken down again. Did YouTube send us an email explaining why the streams were taken down? No. Did they put a notification in the awful creator dashboard to explain what happened? No, the only way we were able to contact them was to go to the old links of the live streams as another account, switch back to Coyote Wild, appeal the community strike, and wait for their reply. YouTube's response, yeah, our bad. That's it. They didn't explain what caused the flag in the first place. They just sent a very short PR-laced, whoops, we'll fix it, and we were on our way. The sad part is Virgil and I got lucky on multiple accounts. Other channels like Leafy's are just poofed from existence. Markiplier and Charlie just got their strikes with no warning and had to use Twitter to get a hashtag trending to make it a PR problem for YouTube. Did you know that channels receive a hidden age rating? Do you know how we know? Because a top tier creator leaked it at the sacrifice of his preferred partnership. YouTube was never going to tell us. YouTube is the world's worst at talking to its creators. I am convinced they want us in the dark because otherwise they are the most incompetent communicators on the internet. YouTube, as I said in the previous video, you have to do better. Yes, right now you are the only game in town, but that's what Walmart thought. Then online shopping and Amazon came along. American cars used to dominate the US car market. Then Japanese cars got really good and really cheap. Will the great empire of YouTube fall tomorrow or even 5 years from now? No. But if they keep making their creators mad, they will go somewhere else. If you keep supporting these problematic creators and keep pushing them, you will never get the legitimacy you are so thirsty for. If you are a content creator looking to make this a job, do not make YouTube your sole source of income or even your sole platform. This can all go up in smoke. Just ask TikTok.